To love is my dharma, that is my swadharma. Like a river, my mission will keep flowing on and on and on. Whether you drink from it, you quench your thirst or not, it is much dependent on you, not me. One day, our Narasimha Murthy was asking me, how is it, Swami, that you keep doing the same thing with so much of love for so many people, whether they follow you, whether they love you, whether they adore you or not, unmindful of that, how do you keep doing this? Generally, if somebody does something for others, at least they expect an acknowledgement, a thank you in return, if not a big favor. You don't even care for that. You keep doing what you have got to do and you are unmindful of what people are doing with it. And I told him, Narasimha Murthy, I am like the river Ganges. It only knows how to flow. It only knows how to reach the ocean. Whether you drink from it, whether you spit in it, whether you worship it, whether you bathe in it, whether you are a sinner or a saint, it really does not matter to the river. Its joy is in flowing and reaching the ocean. My joy is to do what I have got to do, irrespective of what others think of it, how others use it, how others look at it, I do not worry about it. To love is my dharma, that is my swadharma. Swadharmo nidhanashreya, doing your duty, even if you die, it is better, they say, than to do something else. Therefore, I am happy doing what I am doing because to love is my duty, to love is my dharma, to love is my way of life. Love does not desire anything. Love is self its own reward. When you love somebody, you don't expect them also to love you back. For if you truly love, the love will come back to you 10 times more. Some people say, what about that student? What about that devotee? I say, I have no worry about what they think, what they do. Because I only trust my love. If I have loved somebody purely, with all my heart, without any selfish desires, I have no fear about what will happen to anybody because I know they will all come back to me. Nobody can go away from me. Then we told university should give free education and children in return should serve the institution for some time. Some people suggested they should sign a bond which will bind them to this commitment. Probably that is the system that most of the other places follow in order to recover the investment that they make on students. I told them, I don't need any financial bond. I have a bond of love. That will take care. We don't need to sign any other bonds. Therefore, all these people who come to me, not because of anything else. It's only because they experience something which they do not experience anywhere else. What is not there in the world outside? Everything is there. Even God is there everywhere, as the scriptures say. But here is where you experience that purest of love, which is the true form of divinity, and that is why you are drawn to this place. So I have no fear, no anxiety whatsoever, what will happen to the mission, whether these people will come back, whether they will contribute, whether they will participate. I only tell them one thing, let us love them all purely, selflessly, and love will take care of everything. Let us not worry beyond that. Don't worry about what other person is going to do. Worry about whether you are able to love everybody selflessly or not. That's all should be your concern. For I know for sure, nowhere else they will find this kind of love, this kind of purity, this kind of peace. Wherever they fly, ultimately they have to come back to the same branch, to the same nest. Even if somebody goes out looking for it elsewhere, they may find replicas or they may find kind of lookalikes of the same, but they will not find the original love that is possible only with God and not with the world. Therefore, if you also purify your heart, fill it with such pure love, without any desires, without any attachments, you will also experience God's divinity, God's love everywhere, and you will always be happy. Not a moment in your life will be sad. Let this be your effort from today, from this moment onwards, to purify yourself of all the negativity, all desires and attachments, and fill it with pure love of God and experience that everywhere.